Hey guys, Jason here from timberfalls.us. I'm going to try and explain today how I made these chess pieces using the Onefinity CNC, a three-axis machine, and CARVECO Maker. I'm using CARVECO Maker Plus, but everything we're going to do today can be done on the regular version of CARVECO, and I'll go through all the details and everything in just a few minutes.
Okay, once you get CARVECO Maker open, we're going to basically start a new model. We want to enter our dimensions. 1.55 inches wide, 7 inches tall. We're going to leave the resolution to max. And I'm referencing the bottom left corner. Okay, once your model is open, we're going to import our relief. First, if you do not have this ruler information and you don't have the information that follows the cursor, you can get that by showing ruler, showing origin, and showing cursor information. You just click those and it will give you all this information. Okay, so what we're going to do is import our relief. And we're going to do the Dark Knight, or the Undead Knight. Just import our relief here. When it comes in really big. I like to just unclick this inches button, center it down. It brings it to a more manageable size. You can see it's standing up. We need it to lay down, so we're going to rotate that 90 degrees. Okay. And we want to move this to the top of our material. We want it at the top of the material because we're going to use the rest of the material to clamp where all of our clamping pressure is going to be. I like to use two really big clamps to hold the whole bottom piece of the wood. And that's the material where all the clamps are going to go. So to do that, we just move this up. And so we change the Y. And 5 might have been too much. Let's move it down just a little bit. Let's go 4.75. Okay. Okay, and we're also like floating off the, so we want to bring that down to 0. Okay, the first thing we want to do is size the model. Since I'm building a chess set, all of my chess pieces roughly are the same size, or I'm trying to make them the same size. And I do that by just keeping the base of the model the same. The diameter of my two previous pieces was about 1.2 inches. So that's what I'm shooting for, is 1.2 inches. The way to see where it's at now, since it's laying down, we can just paste. And then when you hover your cursor over here, you can see that the base is about 135. What's the biggest number I saw? 1353. So we want it to get down to 1.2, which is where the other chess pieces that I was making, so that they all come out the same. We're going to do that by just changing our Z height. I'm going to reduce this just a little bit. We're going to go, it's 1.48 and some change. We're going to go to 1.32 and shrink our model. We did not undo the paste. So I just want to make sure I undo that paste. Okay, 1.32. Now make sure it's all the way to the zero. And we'll paste that down. Okay, and that's right at it, 1.2. At this time, before I do anything else, I need to save this model. I'm going to save this. This is the Dark Knight, so I'm going to call it DK1. And we've already pasted this down. We need to undo that. Because we need to move this model. Because we're only going to be cutting half of it. So what you want to do is turn the piece so that you can see this line. This is the zero plane of the z-axis. And we're going to drop the model into that so that we're going to cut basically half of it. Now it's not going to be exactly half, and it doesn't have to be half because our material is larger than our piece. So we have extra room in all four directions that this model can float in. So it doesn't have to be right in the middle. We actually prefer it not to be in the middle, and I'll show why in just a second. So we want to drop this model so that this line or plane lines up with everything that we want to carve from the front. And what I mean is when you carve the front, all of the detail that can be reached by the bit as it comes down, everything that could be captured from that bit, you want to make sure that stays above this plane. So if we look at the model here, we can see that all of this cove next to his head needs to be cut from the front direction. We can't cut it from the side because there's no way to get in there. The detail is only forward facing. So that's forward facing detail. The inside of the ear is forward facing detail. So anything that is forward facing detail needs to stay above this. But that's where we're going to bring it to, is to that forward facing detail. So I'm going to drop this down. And the way you do that is we're going to put a negative point. We're going to start with 0.5. Now you can see that forward facing detail right here went past. And see, we would not be able to cut it from the front. We want to capture that, so we went a little too far. We need to make this less. Let's go 4, 5. And now if we look, we can see that we're capturing most of it, maybe just a little bit. Let's try 4, 3. Okay. Now we're getting it. Now you can see that all of this detail here we're going to be able to get. All of this inside of the ear here we'll be able to get from the front. And that's how we want this model to be positioned. Okay. Now that we've shrunk it down, it actually could be moved further up in the material. I want to just move this up a little bit. We can go probably 5. Maybe too. Let's come back a little bit. Okay. And I'm only doing that so that I have more clamping area at the bottom. Once we cut the material, the roughing material on two of the sides, there won't be anything left up the, up top to clamp and put any kind of clamps on. So the entire project has to be clamped from here down. So the more area that you have to clamp on, the better. Okay, now that I like that, we're going to paste that down. And we're going to save the model. And you can see what we're getting from the front. Okay. Now, we're pretty much done creating the front side of the model. So we want to move on to the other three sides. The first thing I want to do before I start creating tool paths, we're going to want to cut the material from around the piece in our roughing pass. But we want to leave the piece attached to the material below. To do that, we're going to designate we're just going to draw basically a rectangle, and the rectangle is what our cutting vector will be. Now, we pull this down into the material. Now, we don't want it to cut all the way through the material. We want it to leave just a little bit so that this remains attached to the base of the wood. Okay, now that we have that vector saved in there, I'm ready to create the other three sides. So what we're going to do, we have this saved. We're simply going to reset our relief. We're going to rotate this 90 degrees. We're going to paste it down. We're going to save this as, we're going to call this DK2. This is side 2. And that's it. Now we're going to reset our relief. We're going to rotate this 90 degrees. We're going to paste this down. Okay, now that we got that pasted down, we're going to save this as DK3. We're going to reset our relief. Rotate 90 degrees. Paste it down. Save as DK4. But that's all we're going to do to make the four sides. We're only using half of the material, so each side is only taking up one half of its respective material. Okay, now we want to start building our tool paths. So to do that, let's We could start here, but I'm gonna start with the first one we did. Let's go back to DK1. Okay. Now, to start that toolpath, we want to paste in our vector line. That's awful high. Let's transform that down. Yeah, I want that to fall inside of the base. Okay, we can start creating our toolpaths. We're going to use that vector inside the vector. For the roughing, we're going to use a 1/8 inch end mill down cut. And for the finishing, we're going to be using a 1/16 ball nose. Now I'm going to leave this as a Rasta. I'm also going to leave this as Rasta. I'm not going to do any profiling. You could add ramping if you wanted to. We're going to define our material, 1.55 inches. And you can see we're only going to be carving the half of it. And calculate. Should be fine. Okay. We're going to save these as separate files. And we're going to save this as DK1, the front side. Now let's bring in the file 2. Sixteenth ball nose for our finishing. Our roughing is the 1/8 end mill. Again, all of our settings are the same. We define our material. And calculate. Oh, we gotta select the vector. And we want to save these. As DK2, or side 2. Move on to side 3. Selected vector, finishing, 1/16, roughing, 1/8 end mill, find the material, and calculate. Save our toolpath. Move on to the final side. Selected vector, ball nose, 1/8 in mill. Okay, let's save this. Before. Okay, now we're ready to load our toolpaths into the machine and go out to the shop and get everything set up.
We're out here at the shop getting ready to start. I wanted to show you my setup first. I screwed a couple of boards down to make a jig to help hold the piece. We're going to use two clamps at the bottom of the piece. And as you remember, all the carving is going to be done at the top. I'm also using a 1/8 shank collet. That's the 1/8 end mill and 1/16 ball nose. The piece has been cut pretty square, so it can slide and change positions. And after each cut, I'll change the position of the block and we'll make another cut. And we'll just go through all the cuts that way. Now, I'm only going to use the clearing path for the left side and the right side. So that was DK2 and DK4. And the reason for that is pretty much once we run those two clearing paths, most of the clearing material will be gone. And so from that point, we're just going to run finishing paths on all four sides. But the first two cuts will be roughing path DK2 and roughing path DK4. Now I'm going to get this all set up and zeroed in, and we'll be back in just a second. Okay, with the material locked in place, we are ready to start our first roughing cut. DK2 is now done. We got the roughing path completed. Everything looks really good. We're going to flip this over and run DK4, the other side of the roughing path. We're going to do both roughing paths before we start our finishing paths. Everything flipped over and locked into place. We're ready to start our DK4 roughing path for the other side. Okay, with DK4 now finished, that completes both roughing paths. You can see we've got a 3D model. We're just going to start doing the roughing. I'm sorry, the finishing paths. Since I roughed the left and right, I'm going to do those finishing paths first. So we're going to start with DK4, the finishing path, and we're going to work backwards. We'll go DK4, and then next I'll flip it over, do the DK2, and then we'll move to the back, DK3, and then last will be DK4. We'll do the face last. The left side is done with the finishing. We're going to flip it over and do the finishing path, which will be DK to the finishing path. I think this side came out really nice. You can see the middle still has a pretty flat, fat spot. We're going to get all those details on the front. So there's going to be another amount of detail that'll get back into the front piece. But that side came out fairly nice. You can see the thickness on the back. Okay, we're going to flip it over and start the second side. Okay, I got the piece flipped over now and clamped back down. We're ready to do the roughing path for this side. And then we'll move to the back, and then last the front. Okay, we just finished with DK2, and I said I was going to do the back next, but actually I think we're going to do the front next. The main reason I got to thinking about the ears, there's going to be some carving and detail on the ears, and this material in the middle is going to be removed from the ears when the front carve. So if I do the back first, that material will likely get removed. And it won't have as much support for carving that detail. I think it's going to just make more sense to go ahead and do the front side, and then we'll do the back side last. And as you can see, we've got very good detail from both sides. And this basically represents the side angle of that detail. The front is going to really narrow it down some and put the detail down through the middle. Okay, we got everything locked in. We're ready to start the front side. Hey guys, I stopped the carve just after it started, and I wanted to show you a problem that you may run into. This piece is... the zero plane is off. I had just started it. If this happens to you during one of your sides where the bit looks like that it's not touching the surface as it goes around, you may need to stop and reset. We're going to reset this again. I'm going to take it all back off, reclamp it back down, reset zero, and start it back again. Just finished the front cut. It looks very nice. We got very nice detail on the eyes, the face. When we get the back, it will get this little edge that's on the side. Everything is looking pretty good. So one more cut to go, and we will be done. So I'm going to flip it over and do the last final cut on the back. Let me get it set up. With the model now turned over, we're ready to do the back and finish up our last cut of the Dark Knight piece. Okay. With the back now done, the Dark Knight piece has now been complete. Time for a coat of Danish oil, a little bit of light sanding, and it's ready to go. And that's how I did the chest pieces, four-sided carving. Thanks for sticking around, and be sure to give us a like and subscribe, and I'll make more videos like this. Thanks, guys.